Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I am Britt, creator of The Style Shaker, your guide to cleaner, greener beauty, skincare, and more. I try products out for you so you know what to buy, more importantly, what not to buy. Today I'm testing out and reviewing the Root Organic Aloe Silk Setting Powder. I have many things to tell you, so if you want to learn more about this, stick around and let's get into it. FYI, I purchased this powder, so you are getting my honest review. No one's paying me to say any of this. If you enjoy seeing these honest reviews and you want to see more of them, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and click that bell icon so you never miss a thing. The Aloe Silk Setting Powder. Very excited to try this. It starts with the first question, which is all about ingredients. How do the ingredients look here? Well, let's see. There are two. There is mica and aloe vera powder. That's it. Ethically sourced mica, made in the USA. Oh, you know what? I forgot to mention the price. It's $16. Whatever, we went out of order. Life happens. Next, coverage. This is really where, well, one of the places in which this aloe silk setting powder really wins. I have a tendency to not be able to see a true distinction between setting powders most of the time. There are a couple that have risen in the ranks. I've talked about them over here before, and I primarily use setting powders under the eye, which some people absolutely do not want to do. I rarely use setting powders all over the face. I haven't really always loved the way it looked because sometimes it mutes things too much. This setting powder is different, and it's different for a number of reasons. I actually loved using it on the rest of my face. It's a heavier weight setting powder. It's not the kind that you open the container and a huge plume comes out. When I applied it, it did this kind of magical, silky, diffusing thing where it set, but it let my skin still kind of shine through a little bit. It wasn't mattifying or chalky at all. It does say that it mattifies and it can get rid of oil. I found it to not be overly mattifying and I liked that. And my skin still looked like skin after applying. So for coverage and finish, I gave it a 5 out of 5 on the scorecard. Blending in, does it play well with other products? Yes, it did a fantastic job with moisturizer underneath. I put a bronzer on top. I had no problems. Also, you can minimize pores. Put this on underneath your foundation and then put a layer of foundation on top. That helps with that diffusion and minimizing of pores. I'd actually prefer it on top of any moisturizer or tinted moisturizer or foundation, but it works either way. Because this is like a heavier weight powder. It doesn't feel heavy, but it's a little bit different. I don't know, you can kind of feel it with the texture. I didn't find it to be as great underneath the eye for me. It wasn't bad, I just preferred it across the rest of the face, which is the total opposite of how I feel about other setting powders, so I thought that was kind of interesting. It received a 4 out of 5 on the scorecard. Next, does it absorb oil, control shine? One of the claims too is that it keeps your foundation on the face. It helps it last longer. You're not shiny, kind of greasy by the end of the day. You keep it looking fresh. I think it did a great job. It actually did control oil. I don't have a ton of oil production, but my skin was freaking out because of a skincare reaction. So I didn't use anything for a while, but then when I used this, it helped keep things even looking. If I needed to just minimize that shine, I applied it in the middle of the day, did a fantastic job, and it didn't look cakey or chalky or powdery. Let my skin look like skin. I don't know, it was like really good. It received a 4 out of 5 on the scorecard there. Staying power, does it last all day? I think it did a good job here. I think it got a little shinier as the day progressed. It actually stayed pretty well. It just wasn't perfect by the end of the day. I can't tell if it made the foundation stay longer. I know it helped it from looking greasy and sliding off the face if it was a more moisturizing foundation, plus I used moisturizer before everything. It received a 4 out of 5 on the scorecard on that question. Does it irritate skin? No irritation. It got a 5 out of 5 on the scorecard. And the final question, keeping it conscious, it did an incredible job from being vegan and cruelty-free to having the refillable packaging. All of it was covered, which is something I have grown to really love and respect and appreciate from this brand. It received a 5 out of 5 on the scorecard. That takes us to the final score of 27 out of 30. Real good. Now it's time for that wrap-up and my final verdict. What do I love? What do I not love about it, right? It gives this great glow. Finally, a differentiator in the setting powder category. I love it across the face. It really just did kind of magical things for my skin. I'm a huge fan of it. And it didn't look heavy or powdery or chalky. I love the price. I love the refill. I love so many things about this powder. Not a fan of? What do I not like? There's a negative I could talk about. It would be that it performed better on the face than under eye for me, but that was such a small thing and I could still use it in both areas. I just preferred all over the face. Would I buy this again? The final verdict, the $1 million question. Yeah, you knew it was coming. Yeah, I would absolutely buy this again.
Yeah.
It's a no-brainer, in my opinion. That is what the Style Shaker scorecard said. That is what I thought. What do you think? Have you tried it? Have you loved it? Did you not like it? Tell me in the comments below. I love hearing from you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did and you found it helpful, make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and click that bell so you never miss another one. Okay, I am off to go test some more Cleaner Beauty products for you, and I will be right back here real soon. Until then, bye.